A 3D game with a third-person perspective needs the function to look around through the camera as well as the movement of the character. Until a few years ago, character movement, camera rotation, and other functions had to be performed at the same time through the touch input function when creating mobile games. Touch input is definitely a good feature, but the more complex the in-game controls become, the more difficult it is to create. This time, we will learn how to rotate the camera in a simpler way than touch input. This tutorial used the Cinemachine Free Look Camera. You can find more information about the Free Look Camera on other YouTube channels, so I will pass to explain it. The rotation of the Free Look Camera is basically done by the input axis name. When the game is running, you will see the camera rotate based on your mouse position. It is easy to use with the default settings, but the constant rotation of the camera causes inconvenience unless it is an FPS game. If you remove the input axis name, you will see that you cannot rotate the camera. Of course, if you increase the input axis value, you can rotate the camera in a specific direction. However, in today's tutorial we will focus on the input axis name. Now that we understand the principle, let's create a function that rotates the Free Look camera by dragging the mobile screen. The main purpose of this tutorial is to have the camera rotate while moving the character. Different functions have to be implemented with multi-touch on the screen. To do this, we will use the UI events we applied to the virtual joystick. Preparation is simple. You only need to prepare an image that covers a certain area of the screen. The hierarchy or child order should be placed before the joystick image so that it does not interfere with joystick use. In addition, by setting the margin of the UI image, it is not disturbed by the use of the smartphone OS. For example, there should be no problem in bringing up the top tab or exiting to the main screen. Now, let's create a script and apply it to the UI image. Unity Engine.UI directive has to be added to allow access to UI features. Then add Event Systems directive to control the UI image. Finally, add the Cinemachine directive to access the Cinemachine Free Look camera features. We need an image variable to detect a mouse button or finger touch. And we will add eye drag handler so that we can handle the event when dragging over the image. The basic conditional statement of the onDrag function operation is the same as the method used in the virtual joystick tutorial. Let's proceed quickly. Let's debug to see if the basic function is working correctly. Dragging over the image confirms that the onDrag function works well. On the other hand, it was also confirmed that the function does not work when dragging outside the image area. Now that the basic functionality works, let's get down to making the free look camera rotate with our intent. Let's add a variable to contain the free look camera. Let's apply a free look camera to the variable we created. When the onDrag function is executed, you can put mouse X and mouse Y in each input axis name variable of the free look camera. To do this, we'll create two string variables, defaulting to mouse X and mouse Y. To use the x-axis of the free look camera, the m_x-axis function is required. Then we're ready to apply the variable via the m_input_axis_name function. Finally, apply the string variable we created and our code is done. The process for moving the y-axis of the camera is the same as the previous method. Now let's run the game. Dragging over the image confirms that the camera rotates. However, the problem arises that the rotation of the camera persists when the mouse button is released. This is because the variables remain in the camera's X and Y axis input axis name. We will inherit iPointDownHandler and iPointUpHandler to handle image click release. We will make the onDrag function run automatically when the image is dragged. We will write a code that deletes the variables of input axis name of each X and Y axis when clicking on the image is released. When I release the mouse button, I'll notice that the camera's rotation stops immediately. However, sometimes the rotation of the camera does not stop and the slight movement remains. The camera is constantly rotating due to the value of input axis value. Code has been added so that the axis value of the X and Y axis becomes 0 when the mouse click is released. We can see that the camera rotates and stops perfectly. It is also confirmed that the axis name and value are reset when the image is unclicked. In the next time, we will implement the sensitivity of the camera rotation and the inversion function of the y-axis control at runtime. Thank you. See you next time.